All right. 3, 2, 1. Welcome to our first episode of No Conditions. I'd like to welcome my first guest. It's a privilege and an honor, Miss Paloma. How are we?
Hi.
So I'm really excited about this. This is my first ever episode to be aired on YouTube and all that fun stuff. And what are your thoughts on this? I mean, are you...
No pressure on me.
No. I mean, probably 20 people will listen to this, more than likely.
No.
You don't think so?
Well, 23.
I get my mom and her friends and all those people to come out and support. Maybe they'll do car washes for me and I can...
Most of your mom's friends probably can't even hear anyway. I know, they're gonna be like, I'd be like, just sit there.
Most of them, whenever I told them I was going to be doing a podcast, they were like, what is that? They thought it was a sexual position at first. And then I was like, no. And then they thought it was a cult.
That's so funny because I was telling my mom about it and she's just like, what is that? And I had to break it down to her and she's still like, what do you mean? I was like, fuck, never. How many fucking years have you been in this country?
It's legal.
You're a goddamn citizen. Jeez. You don't even know what that is. Get it together, Mom. It's time to put you in a home. I've been waiting for the final, like, okay, this is it. It's go time. Let's put you in a home. And this is it.
Every time she gets like an ingrown toenail, you're like, go to the light. You wouldn't want to live like this. You don't want to live with this type of hell.
Every time she takes a nap, I put a mirror underneath her nose. And I was like, today's the day.
Today. And then it doesn't happen.
And then I'm like, fuck.
It doesn't happen.
Yeah.
Every single time. My mom, every time I piss her off, the hours of labor go up. Every single time. It doesn't matter. Every time. And I notice that you do that with your son, too. You're like... At first, it was 2 days. Now, it's like 2 weeks.
It's like...
I was cut from hippeth to hippeth.
Yeah, let him piss me off and I'll be like, I was in labor from 2001 to 2002. And they didn't have any tools when you were going to be born. So
they gave me a stick to bite on.
Yeah, it was barehanded.
That poor thing. I want to talk about your son, about how opposite you guys are. He is the most coolest cat I've ever met.
Oh, he's so smart. The opposite of me?
You're cool, but he is like...
He's like an adult.
He is.
Yeah, and I'm so not.
No.
I know.
He's like, Mom, don't embarrass me.
Yeah, he's so...
How old is he?
He's 17. Mm-hmm. He'll be 18 in June, but he's always been like that. Like, since he was little... I'm pretty sure I told you about when we were going to go to, we went to the movies and it was him and his best friend. And I didn't want to go see, it was probably some Star Wars movie, which is like 18 hours long. Mm-hmm. So I was like, I'm going to go run errands. You guys go to the movies. I'll meet you guys over. I have to go to my bank afterwards. So they called, we're leaving the movies. I was like, okay, go to Chase Bank. And they had a adoption fair going on, right? And
for dogs,
of course. Uh-huh. Yeah, not kids. I wouldn't be there if it was kids. But it was for dogs, and there was this dog, and it wasn't usually a breed. I adore every single dog that there is on this planet, but it wouldn't have been one that I picked out. But for some reason, the dog was like, he looked into my soul, and I was like, I need this dog. And my son and his best friend walked up and they're like, okay, Mom, let's go eat or whatever. And I was like, hey, we need to get this dog. And he's just like, no, we don't. We have two at home. And no, we don't. We don't need another one. And I was like, yeah, we do. And he's just like, no. And he broke it down like, Mom, that's going to be 3 vet bills. And that's going to be like, because I cook for my dogs. So he was, yeah, no, it's not weird. That's the healthiest thing that you could do for your pets. But since you don't love your animals.
Right.
Yeah. So I was just like, it's okay. You know, we can do this. And he's just, he totally broke it down, gave me all the reasons. And I was just like, he's all, give me a good reason of why we should get another one. And I'm like, because he's cute. And my son literally made me cry because he was just like, no, he was like, get in the car and let's go. Like, and usually that's like supposed to be my job. Uh-huh. And I was just like, no, you're so mean. I hate you. Don't talk to me the whole way. Like, I pitched a fit. People stared at me. Like, it was.
I'm surprised he didn't grab you by the ear.
I know. And he's just like, get in the car. I don't want to hear anything about it anymore. Like, yeah, like, he talks to me. He raised me. And that's honestly the truth, because if you knew me as a child, which you did, I was horrible and I was a hoodlum until he saved me and he was born. And he's just like, you got to pay your bills. You got to go to work every day.
And you're like, I just really want a puppy.
Yeah. And I'm just like, can we get more dogs? Like, that's just, I have a one track mind. Can we get more dogs? Like, please. That's, I just need more dogs. And Red Bull.
If you ever win the lottery, you would probably have a whole entire plantation full of all the dogs that, which if you do win the lottery, I want to live there with you in your mansion.
And as long as you have doggy doors in every single wall of your home, I'll build you your own home so you can have your privacy. But you have to have, like, you have to have access. My dogs have to have access to your home. That means, hey, I'm paying the bills. All right. So I'll build you your dream mansion. Uh-huh. And you could have every type of knickknack you want in there. It doesn't, you could have coffee makers in the toilet with your bidet. Because how
convenient. Hey, I don't care what anybody says. A bidet, not to change the subject, but a bidet. It is true. When you go somewhere and you have to dookie and you walk in and you realize that there's not a bidet, you feel like. You feel like you're medieval, like you're, you know, disgusting, what? That you have to wipe your butt.
You know what? It's no so water. Funny because I remember the days that you told me that you went camping and you shit in a bucket. Oh, I'm sorry. Dookie in a bucket. Dookied. And you get a bidet and now all of a sudden you're like,
I'm way better than
you're like fancy schmancy. Yeah. You're like on a whole nother class.
I'm
now
above everybody.
You're above
everybody. And once you do it, like you hit that, you get that like spot where you're like, oop. That's going to be clean.
Yeah. Well, but I think it's funny because I still remember when you're like, oh, my God, my husband's the best. He got me my own bucket.
When we went on a camping trip, we had it was called the Bubicon. Shout out to the Bubicon peeps. And we had to it was dry camping. So you could only take what could fit in your Jeep and the Jeep couldn't have any top or doors on it. And we went camping for 2 days and my biggest fear was pooping outside because I had never really, I'd peed, but I'd never pooped outside. And I was so nervous. Like, I'm a nervous sweater by nature. And so when we were driving there, I was thinking, I'm just not going to shit. I'm just going to hold it for 2 days. I've done that before whenever I ate a whole block of cheese.
Yeah.
And I'm going to hold it and I'll go when I get home. And everyone was kind of like on brown watch with me. They were like staring at me and I'd get the little sweat going and, you know, crowning. I knew that was happening. And so the next morning, I remember I got up before everybody, it was like 6 o'clock, and I got up out of our tent and I made a fire for the first time and I started coffee and I sat down with my cup of coffee and a cigarette. And I was like, this is amazing. This is like why I'm here, is to be zen. And then it hit me that I'm gonna be pushing daisies pretty soon out of my butthole.
All of a sudden Jesus came down and Jesus shook her hand,
looked at me and went, you're gonna shit yourself. And so I'd never done it before, and so I went and grabbed a roll of toilet paper and I grabbed wipes and I went and found a tree that was probably like the size of like a walnut tree. And I was like a Saint Bernard. I thought if I couldn't see you, you couldn't see me. It took me 45 minutes. 45 minutes. And I used
Though it was like right there.
It didn't matter.
It got scared.
I have a very shy sphincter. And so I went and I was so excited. And I didn't know that your voice echoed in the woods. And so I went and I woke my husband up. I'm like, honey, you're never going to guess. And he went, what? And I said, I pooped. And you could hear clapping throughout the whole entire camp. And he looked at me, and in true husband fashion, big daddy fashion, he was amazing. He looked at me and he goes, I am so proud of you. I'm like, I know. You want to come see? And he goes, sure. And so he gets up, out, rolls himself out of the tent, goes and looks. And he's like, honey, you did so amazing. Next time you might want to go more than 10 feet away from the tent. And I kind of knew, since I could see him through the flap of the tent, that I was maybe a little too close. But
yeah, but I mean, you don't want to go into the wilderness.
No, I know what it's like. Fat people never make it out of the woods.
You could have got lost. You could have. Yeah,
it would have been horrible. So you, I didn't do that. And it was terrifying. And
safety first. Safety first. Is what I
always say. Yeah. 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 So we were, that was my, that's my, my dookie story.
That's amazing.
Have you ever pooped outside?
No.
On purpose.
Sober.
That's so drunk. Somebody shit in your pants.
It wasn't my shit. I swear.
That's not me.
Not that. You know what? Okay, one time I was hauling to Petaluma, California, and on the way back, this 18-wheeler, okay, so you have to pass this one-way bridge, one way there, one way back, and on the way back, I was already unloaded and everything. I haul, you know, I haul cattle, so this was years ago when I would still haul to Petaluma, and there was an 18-wheeler, and I don't know what it did, but it was flipped over both lanes.
Oh.
Yeah. And so it was in the middle of both lanes because, I mean, it was just these little tiny, there are these little tiny lanes. And so obviously I was going to be in traffic for a while. Luckily, I had a 30-foot livestock trailer attached to me, which is like a huge porta potty.
I was going
to
say.
Yeah. And I mean, I had boots on and everything, you know, the boots that I wear for work.
Uh-huh.
And so I don't want to say that I pooped. I'm pretty sure I peed because I think I was in traffic for hours. But it was so bad that I had people asking me, can I use...
You, like, people would come up to your truck and ask you to use...
Yeah, because we were in we were just stuck for so many hours. I want to say that we were there for like 5 hours.
Did you let him?
Yeah, of course. You know what? Yeah, I know I'm a dick, but I mean... I was stuck there. What was it? That would have been awkward. Them staring at me like, fucker, you wouldn't let me use it. No, I'm not going to clean up.
I'm
going to
let the cow, you know, shit in here before
I did think about it like, fuck, I'm going to have to go to the ranch. And I mean, I have a pressure washer. So it's not like I would have had to like scoop out the shit or anything. So, but still, like when they're like, can we please use your, you know, the trailer? We really have to go to the bathroom. I was just like,
no, yes.
You know what I mean? I'd kind of think about it.
No, and yes, you can.
Yeah, and then I was like, I should just start fucking charging them. Like,
dude,
number,
you could have made a shit.
It would have been like, you know what, in Mexico, if you go to the, like, a market, they have a bathroom, you know, like the public bathroom. They charge you to use it, and they ask you, what are you going to do? That depends. So, because they need to know how much toilet paper.
An uno or a dos?
Yeah, uno o dos. So you're like... 4 squares or 48 squares. You know what I mean? And I'm not exaggerating that. And
they seriously charge you to?
Yes. You cannot go into any public bathroom without them charging you.
Wow.
That I'm going to say the majority of, I mean, unless you're in a restaurant, but like if you, or like the mall or whatever, but like the market, the grocery store, it's kind of like, it's an indoor outdoor market. And so they have the bathrooms right there. And if you, they ask you, you know, uno, dos, and you're just like, dame mucho papel, which means give me a lot of paper.
We're going to be here a while.
I just ate at the taco stand on the corner. Give me a lot, you know?
And give me a lot. It's not going to take long.
Yeah. And you have to pay them. You pay them like it would be equivalent to probably like, I don't know, a dollar or two.
I don't blame people. Do you have any idea what people do to public restrooms? It is absolutely disgusting.
And you know what? That's true. It keeps it cleaner and you don't waste a bunch of toilet paper.
No.
You
see, if they had a bidet, they would cure all the toilet paper problems.
Yeah, they would. But they don't. I'm pretty sure that's more like the city.
Mm-hmm.
The city is more refined than I'm from like a smaller. I'm kind of more like.
What's the name of the city?
San Isidro, where I'm from. And then we'll go to another town to do our like grocery shopping, which is more kind of like a Yuba City. Like it wouldn't be like Sacramento, but it'd be like a Chico. Or no, it'd be probably smaller than a Chico. More like a Yuba City. Mm-hmm. Like they have everything there. But you'd have to go somewhere else.
Do you ever see yourself going there, like living there, like when you get older? Oh,
yeah, yeah. I definitely, my grandma actually left us the house where my mom and all my aunts and all them were born there. So we have the property and we're actually looking into building a house there. I love where I'm from. Would I go to, like, let's say where El Chapo's from? No. But I would absolutely love to go and have a home and vacation there 18 times a year.
Uh-huh.
No, like, you know, for Christmas and, you know, not so much summer because it's hot. But
see, I couldn't. You'd have to get on a plane. I don't like flying.
I don't like flying either.
I don't like driving long distances. I don't really care for.
You don't like leaving your house.
My 5 mile radius rule.
I know you don't.
Like,
at
driving
all.
Out to CVS gives me a nosebleed. I like my little sanctuary at home.
If I break down, I really have to, like, you have to be my absolutely last resort.
Yeah, your lifeline better be somebody, and I get lost.
You're like, is there a way I could send somebody?
I have AAA and cash.
So do
is
I.
Is there anybody out there that would be willing? I could send somebody. There's a lot of people out there that like to drive. Not me. I drove to Vegas.
That is my, don't even mention Vegas. Okay, we went from talking about my son, and let me tell you something about Vegas, okay? I drove to Vegas. I don't know how you can say somebody that will not pass CVS
drove to Vegas.
I don't know how. And you say you enjoy that drive. I almost died driving.
Well, you did not.
No, okay. Let me tell you. Okay. Let me tell you. And no lie, like, you could talk about any kind of topic, and I'll have a story because that's just the type of life I have. Like, yes. It's a shit show all the time. Okay. So, Vegas. Boom. I'm a big boxing fan. And when I say box, for all you people out there, it's not UFC. It's real boxing.
Mm-hmm.
Like Muhammad Ali, Mike Tyson, which is one of the great ones. Julio Cesar Chavez, which is that's Mexico's all-time greatest fighter. Okay, I'm a huge boxing fan. Me and one of my best friends went to a boxing fight in Vegas. That was the plan. We got our tickets. We saved up all year to get these tickets because these tickets are a down payment for a car, okay? So, and I'm not talking about some little piece of shit. I'm talking, like, you want to get a Mercedes, you're going to have this kind of down payment to get it, no matter how good your credit is. Yeah, cash, unreported cash.
I could either have a car paid cash for or row 6 seat 7 and 8.
Yeah, no, they weren't even a car paid. It wasn't like buying a car. It was like putting a ginormous, I could have bought a car with what we spent on these tickets. It wouldn't have been a Mercedes. It would have been just a down payment for a Mercedes. Uh-huh. But anywho, so that's when I used to haul to Petaluma. I'm gonna say it was 2015-14 when we went. And wait a minute, what year is it?
It's 2019. Ding
okay,
dong.
Scratch that. It was like 2005 when we went. So we went and I drove to Petaluma. I get up around 4. When I used to go over there, I'd get up around 3 or 4 to haul. And I said, I'm going to go haul. You know, she was working that day. I said, when I come back, we're going to go. And so I'm pretty wiry when I come home because, you know, you wake up and you're just going. So early in the morning, it's hard for me to go just take a nap afterwards. And so I said, you know what? I'm back. It was, I don't know, like 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I said, are you done? Are you off of work? She, yeah. Okay. I'm on my way. Have your stuff ready. Let's just go. I'm going to drive until I'm tired. And then we'll, you know, you could trade me. And she's like, all right. And I go, so you're, and I had been asking her for months, you know how to drive stick, right? Cause during the time I had a little stick shift Honda Accord, a little white one.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, you know how to drive stick, right? I've been asking her for months. Of course I do. I'm not stupid. Okay. Well, I was the stupid one for taking her word for it. Okay. So I drove, no lie, went to Petaluma, came back, picked her up, drove. I drove all the way to, like, we were already in Nevada. Like, we were out of California.
Yeah. It takes like 9 hours from our house to there.
To out of To Vegas?
Yeah. It takes 9 hours from my house. Well,
I don't know where we went because it seriously felt like 48 hours. Okay. That's what it felt like. Okay. So we were already like pretty close to the border of California. And I was like, you know, I'm getting super tired. Can you drive? And she's like, yeah, no problem. Put it into fifth gear. And I was like, it's in fifth gear. And she's like, no, I know. But like, I was like, what are you talking about? At the next exit, I'm going to pull over. And she's like, no, I don't do it that way. I was like, you don't do what way? And she's like, I don't drive stick shift that way. And I was like, that's the only way to drive stick shift. I need to get out and you're going to have to switch me spots.
You're going to have to do some foot action.
Yeah. Yeah. And she's like, no, I don't know how to do all that. You have to actually put it into fifth gear and then I'll jump over you. And I was like, the fuck are you talking about? I was like, I'm sorry. Can I cuss?
Yeah.
Okay. I was like, what are you talking about? And she's like, well, that's how I drive stick. I was like, that is absolutely how you don't drive stick. You have to work it up to fifth gear as you're moving your feet. What are my feet going to be doing? How is the car going to be moving when you're jumping over me? Like, and she's like, it'll be fine. I was like, and mind you know, I like to drink Red Bull.
Yes.
I was so tired. I probably had like 36 Red Bulls, maybe 8 5-hour shots because I was hallucinating by the time I got there. I was so tired. I seriously was like, look at all the water. And she's like, what are you talking about? Water. We're in the desert. And I was like, fuck you. That's how tired I am. Okay. So long story short, I got there. We were going to be there like 3 days. So don't drink 36 Red Bulls and 5-hour shots because it will constipate you. Something fierce. I don't think I shit for a month after that. We went Cinco de Mayo weekend, which is the 5th of May. I probably shit towards the end of June. Like, it was so bad. Like, I had like 30 pounds of shit in my tiny belly.
You shit so much, you probably fell back into like 2 sizes pants.
Yeah, I shit back all the way. I shit so much.
You went down to your birth weight.
It took me back to the 90s. That's how much I fucking shit. I was just like, oh yeah, it was so bad that I wanted to leave a day early. I was like, let's go. And she's like, really? You want to go? I was like, yeah, I want to fucking go and start driving another 38 hours because that's what I have to look forward to. Like, I couldn't even enjoy my time there. I couldn't even enjoy my time there because, and then, so once we got there, another mistake I made was letting her be in charge of the hotel. Okay. I said, get a decent one because, I mean, we spent so much money on these tickets. This was my son's college fund that I spent. And it's not. But I'm saying, like, I spent so much money on these tickets, which were pretty fucking good tickets. No one's going to take that away from me, how yeah. close we were. But so I said, just, you know, budget on the hotel. And so I asked her, where'd you get a hotel at? I'm thinking, at the very worst, it's going to be like a Best Western or even, you know what, a Motel 6. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like
anyone. Yeah.
Anyone at like just something Super 8 or whatever they're called. Like, you know, something not grand.
You're not going to get a waffle.
Yeah. Breakfast. I'm not going to get some free Danish and a yogurt. You know what I mean? They're not going to have any kind of coffee pot, you know. No, she's like, oh, I got a good one next to the MGM. I was like, okay, cool. It's not going to be that bad, you know? So we got there and they're like, okay, it's going to be, I don't even remember how much it was. But when we pulled up, I was like, this isn't the hotel, right? And she's like, yeah, this, there was what they call ladies of the night standing everywhere. And I was like, it's normal. It's Vegas. It's legal here. You know what I mean? No. We got to the hotel and they're like, how many hours are you going to stay? And cash only. And we're like, what? Like cash only, you know, who carries cash anymore? Even back then. You know, in 2005, like, usually everything's debit card, right? Mm-hmm. And they're like, nah, cash only. Like, and oh, how many shit. Hours? And I was like, well, fuck, how many hours is in 3 days? I think it's 72 hours. And they looked at us like, you're going to be doing a lot of fucking. And I was like, no. Like, I'm not setting up shop in your hotel. Like, And they're like, yeah, it's by, it was a by the hour hotel. Oh,
how much did it cost you for the 3 days?
For 3 days, it was probably like, it was like, I don't know. And mine, and it was a Cinco de Mayo weekend. I want to say it was probably like $300. And because the prices went up because it's Cinco de Mayo.
And then how much were your prescriptions to get rid of the STDs that you got from the bed?
Well, the prescriptions were a little bit cheaper. Hey, if you can get rid of it with a penicillin shot, then it's not that bad.
It don't count.
You know what?
It'll be fine.
No, you know what? I'll be honest. It was not. Okay. It was not.
It didn't suck.
No, the best time. But the best thing was the fight. But during that time, she was married. During that time. Mm-hmm. So her husband was calling nonstop. And I was still not married. But I was in a relationship during that time. And he wouldn't stop calling. So it's like we didn't go to any clubs. We didn't enjoy Vegas. Mm-mm. Like it wasn't like a Vegas trip like it should have been. Mm-hmm. You know, I should have been thrown up on myself somewhere.
In your shoes. She should have been holding your hair.
Exactly. I should have been, you know, doing the walk of shame in the morning. But instead, I was constipated. And all we did was eat. Like, literally, that's all we ate. And then we did go. After the fight, we went to, what's it called, Fremont Street. Mm-hmm. Because she had to have a fucking fried Twinkie. Mm-hmm. Okay, so mind you, we got one of those City Pass bus passes. Yeah. Which is a pretty smart thing to do when you're over there. And we rode over there. It took us like an hour. Because it's Cinco de Mayo and the bus stopped, like no lie, every couple inches. And finally, when we got there, it was so late. We like finally found the place and we're like, we want 2 fried Twinkies, please. They're like, the kitchen's closed.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. And so I was like, let's do the zip line. She didn't want to do it. And so I was like, can we go to like a strip club? And she didn't want to see vagina. And I was just, I mean, neither did I.
Party pooper.
Party pooper. Neither did I. But I wanted to be able to say, hey, I went to a strip club in Vegas.
Yeah.
And then when the strippers got close to me, I'd be like, leave me alone.
I have no money.
I have no money. I think I'm staying right next to you, too.
Are you in 1A?
I know. Are you in 1A? I think I'm your neighbor. Let's have coffee in the morning.
I went to a strip joint in New Orleans. I did. I was with.
Was it dark in there?
Yeah, it was. And you know what I was surprised about is the amount of couples that were in there.
You know what? I'm going to be honest. Like, if I was in a serious relationship, I think that's awesome.
Yeah. And it was my idea. Like, we were walking down Bourbon Street, which I love New Orleans. Everybody in my family and all my friends know that New Orleans has my heart. I went there. I loved it. I loved everything about it. That place is, like, it's just, I don't know. You walk there. Like, I cried whenever I left. That's really how much I loved New Orleans. Yes. It was phenomenal.
Is it like me in Disneyland?
Yes. Like just everything is just so amazing there. And we went to Bourbon Street. But what people don't tell you is when you go to Bourbon Street, we were there 2 days after Mardi Gras. And my mother-in-law, God rest her soul, she wanted a Mardi Gras doll. That's all she wanted. She was like, I want a Mardi Gras doll. That's all that I want. Da, 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 da. So
what's a Mardi Gras?
It looks like Mardi a Gras jester. Doll. It looks like a jester. Jester.
What's
like,
a jester? Remember, like, English is my second language.
I know. It's like a.
I know what a jester is. Like a clown. Being a dick.
Yeah. Yeah. And so anyway, we went to Bourbon Street and it's like 11 o'clock at night. Right. And I got my video camera out and I think I videotaped a bunch of people who were earning beads. And we go there and I said, my mother-in-law goes, oh, here's a store. And every store on Bourbon Street had the exact same shit on their window. So you walk in and it's like an ABC store that you get, you know, at all these different locations, all these destinations. And we walked in and it's like Mardi Gras doll, Mardi Gras doll, Mardi Gras doll. Like the shelves were loaded and there's no partition or anything to let you know when the Mardi Gras dolls are no longer there on the shelf. And it was just big, giant dongs. Like every...
Like dicks?
Yes. They even had antique ones. Like any and every kind. Like some with faces, some with big noses. Like
dicks with character.
Exactly. And so I was like, oh. She's all, what do you think about this one? And so I stood in front of her. I'm like, that one's perfect. Let's go. And then finally I got to thinking, she has 5 kids. Like she's seen...
She needs to bring them home dicks too.
She knows what this looks like. And finally I just moved out of the way because she was going to elbow me. And she's like, oh my God. And so we walked out. She was like in her 70s at the time.
So she didn't recognize the dick?
No, she did. But she was like, oh my God. And so she paid for her dolls. She left. And then I looked up and there was Larry Flint's Hustler Club. And I asked my husband, I says, do you want to go in there? And he's like, are you serious? Yeah, absolutely. Let's go in there. We went in there. The cover was $20 a piece, which was bullshit because at midnight it's free.
Oh.
And so we paid $40.
You should have been like,
in.
My husband better get a blowjob.
He better get something out of it. Went in there and got $7 Coors Lights.
What?
$7
beers.
Did
they serve breakfast?
No, they didn't even have peanuts.
I wouldn't want to eat peanuts in there.
But at least have the option. At least sort of apps.
Yeah, something.
And so we walked in and it was weird because most of the girls, like they were obviously
rough around the edges.
They're the Wednesday crew. Oh.
Wednesday afternoon.
Yeah.
You had a pregnant dancer in there.
You could see your cesarean scar or episiotomy scar.
Cover your track marks for Christ's sakes. You're pregnant.
What's that?
I know. I think you still have a syringe in your thigh. Put it away. Is that a prop?
And one of our buddies said he went to a strip joint and it was a juice bar where they get completely naked. Yeah. I go, how was it? And he goes, I don't know. She got on the pole and when she spread her legs, we saw her episiotomy scar.
Is that a juice bar? Is that what? Okay. So
they don't serve alcohol. I think you get like
juice.
And then
they show you the juice.
They show you.
That's probably why you can't get too drunk.
Because
the guys are going to be like, vagina. I didn't want to say the P word because I'm trying to keep it classy.
Classy. Yeah.
Yeah.
But no, I remember he was like, it was disgusting. We had to leave. But this one that we went to in New Orleans, it was great. It was like, I mean, that was obviously the first time I'd ever been to one before, but I didn't feel dirty and I didn't feel weird. I didn't feel anything.
You didn't feel like you needed a
bath afterwards.
A shot or anything.
And the seats were very plush and comfy.
Are you sure that wasn't just like slippery?
Yeah.
You're like, I don't know if this is soft or it's wet or.
Is it damp?
Yeah. It feels kind of moist.
Is it cold?
Yeah. Smells kind of nutty in here.
Did somebody recently mow some lawn? I smell grass
in
what
here.
What is that?
Fresh
mowed lawn and vanilla. I was told all strippers wear vanilla too.
Oh God, the vanilla musk. I'll be like, tuck that string back up in there. Oh God, yeah. I think that'd be totally cool. You totally got a visual. Tuck that string back up in there. God, you couldn't take a couple days off. At least you could make sure that the string was tucked in. I couldn't do it, especially like if it was my menstrual, because I don't use tampons.
No.
I'm Mexican. We don't do that. Uh-uh. So, and I use like, I mean, they look like mattresses. I'd be having to go out there in like some big underwear.
In your yoga pants.
In my yoga pants. And I'd be like, hey, boys, this is all you're going to see for 3 or 4 days. Yeah, I couldn't do it.
Oh, I can't dance. And they don't have a fire pole that I can swing on. So
yeah,
I don't think that they're.
My pad would get in the way. My pad would get in the way. I'd be like, I can't reach that pole with this thing in between us. Yeah, I wouldn't be able to do it. But I think it would, like, in a relationship, I think that that's awesome if you have that kind of connection with.
I think he was totally shocked that I was willing to go in there. But I didn't care. It didn't.
But
I mean, most of the girls, whenever they don't have their makeup on, they look like they're, like, 18. They're young.
Even with the makeup. Yeah. I mean, it's like.
He wasn't impressed. And I was picturing, like.
I'd be like, did your daddy tell you you were the best kisser? That's horrible. I shouldn't have said that.
You're such a good dancer. Oh,
it all started when my daddy said I was the best French kisser. Oh, God, that's horrible. I'm going to go to hell.
Oh, God.
But you know what? At the same time, I say that, but I do have a bit of a jealous streak in me. So I think it would be okay. But if they were like to pay my man too much attention, I'd be like, How do you know this bitch?
Yeah.
Like, where does she know you from? Why is she so comfortable with you?
Why is she taking a five?
Yeah, why are you giving her, why are you even giving her any money? We just paid $20 at the door. Yeah. She doesn't need anything.
$14 for a beer.
Look at, you see that syringe in her arm. Obviously, you're just going to support her habit. And she's 8 months pregnant. And to top it off, she has an Audi, which is disgusting.
Exactly.
Poke that belly button back in, because I don't want to see it.
Ew.
Ew, that's gross.
Ugh. But no, I didn't, I love New Orleans. I would go back.
I've always wanted to go. I've always wanted to go to Graceland, to mm-hmm. Memphis. And so I told myself, when I go to Graceland, I'm going to go to New Orleans. Even though it is very high in crime.
It's the most beautiful. I have a lot of people.
It's the most beautiful, dangerous city in the world.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It is eeks. I love it. We went to the plantation. We went to the the cemeteries are what does
I would
it
love
for
to
me.
Go to the plantations. I'd be like, take me back to the good old days
where I had to wear a dress and I didn't have to
I
work.
Know. And I could just be like, oh, Lordy. And just, you know, wear a steel corset in the summer.
Have the small waist.
Have a mammy.
Yeah.
I would love to have them. You know what, though? I don't think that would work for me. I think I would be the one being a mammy.
I think you would be the mammy.
I'd be the mammy. Never mind. Scratch that.
Scratch
but
it. I would be I'd be the one that they'd like nickname Peaches or like.
Yeah.
Oh, there's Peach.
You'd be the poor white trash.
Yeah. Have all the barking dogs out in the front yard with like three or four stagecoaches that don't run.
And then your husband / brother would come out. Yeah.
My brunkle.
Your brunkle. Oh, that's horrible.
That's terrible. We're gonna get sued.
We're gonna so get sued.
And we're keeping it classy.
Yes. We're yes. I think I've classy. Only said the F word like
20 times.
Exactly.
I know. Normally it's flying out of your mouth, but you haven't said that. And I'm so proud of you.
Thank you. I've been trying.
Have you?
I have been trying. I wanna make a good impression to your mom's 20 friends.
Exactly.
Because you know
well,
I don't
23.
I don't have any.
No.
I have three.
Yeah.
I have three friends.
Uh-huh.
And that's it.
Well, that's okay.
That's okay.
That's okay. I have friends and I'm pretty sure they're not gonna be surprised at anything that I have to say.
No.
Everything that I've talked about, I've said to them. So I mean, they've all heard me fart and burp and
yeah,
most of
see,
them. You know, whenever you hit that point in a friendship, whenever you can poop while you talk on the phone.
Yeah, see, I don't do any of those things because I'm a lady.
You don't FaceTime.
After I said that I was constipated for a month and a half, that was the worst. I mean, I didn't stop drinking Red Bull, but I just don't drink.
Did you see Jesus?
I did, and he's like, "Put that fucking can down, Paloma. You're fucking crazy." I was like, "One more.
I'm going to do it.
One more." Like, it was so bad. The Red Bull was, like, making me drowsy. That's
really?
It was just, I was so tired. I was exhausted. I had been up since 3 in the morning that day, and then when I came back, and then we hit traffic and everything, so it just took so much longer. I mean, we didn't leave at a good time. We left like at 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So, and then I don't know what way you guys went, but I know that we went all the way down south,
mm-hmm.
and then we made a left somewhere. That's all I know. And that's all I remember.
Mm.
And my friend was navigating and I was like, "We're good?" "Yeah, we're good." And so I was like, "Okay." And she's like, "I'll just tell you when to stop." And I was like, "Okay." And put it to you like this, okay? You know how much I eat. So we stopped to go eat somewhere. And I mean, sometimes I'm not that hungry. So I'll feel like I'm super hungry and I'll just eat. And then I can't eat all my food. But I don't like to waste food.
So you're going to stomach it and
hammer down. Yeah. So I don't
like
to waste food. So I'll just eat it sometimes. Well, on this rare occasion, I was like, you know, I'm just going to save it. And it was a Carl's Jr. hamburger. And I was like, I'm just going to save it. I'll be on the road later. I'll want to eat it.
Mm-hmm.
So I wrapped it up and I threw it in my purse, you know, because that's just the normal place to put
classy.
It. Yeah. I put it in my purse. I don't want people to look at my food. So the next day, my friend is getting ready at the hotel and she's drawing her eyebrows on. And that takes like 18 hours. Mm. And I'm just like, hurry up. Because I've grown mine out for years now. But my friend likes to still hold on to that that eyebrow pencil.
Uh-huh.
So I was just like, hurry up. I'm starving. I'm so hot. Like, I was getting shaky. You know how I get in the morning. Mm. I can't even start my day without eating like three times a day.
Uh-huh.
I'm not three times a day. That's crazy. Three times in the morning. Yeah. I need like three breakfasts to get me going.
It's like your sugar goes low, but
it does. I feel like I'm diabetic and nobody.
You're not diabetic.
You say that, but I'm telling you that's how I feel.
Oh, okay.
People don't get that. I feel like I'm going to faint. I feel like I'm going to throw up if I don't get enough food in me in the morning. I don't know what it is. So anyways, I am diabetic. No.
I always wanted a thyroid problem. Yeah. Given anything.
I had the thyroid problem when I was younger. But anyways, so my friend's taking 18 hours to draw those damn eyebrows on. And I was like, come on, you're happy today. Draw on your happy eyebrows. And so
put an arch in it.
Let's just go. Let's just do straight lines. Right now you have no personality.
Yeah. So you just have no emotion.
No emotion because it's too early in the morning. And so I was like, oh my God, I'm going to die here in this prostitute's bed, you know, next to like thousands of bastard children. And so I was like, whatever, I'm going to smoke. I'm going to chew on a cigarette or something. So I was like, lo and behold, I opened up my purse and there's my hamburger.
You did not eat it.
Of course I did. And you know what? It fell out of the wrapper.
Oh, God.
Yeah. So there was a considerable amount of lint, a little bit of tobacco on that thing. And I just shook it off and I ate it.
I'm like a champ.
I'm a survivor.
I'm sure that's not the worst you've put in your mouth before. So I think you're okay.
I'm going to say that you're 100% accurate.
I'm about 99.9% sure that you're correct.
You are correct. So,
have you ever had gum that fell out and you were like,
No. I'd have to draw the line somewhere. I mean, if it fell out of my mouth, then that means that didn't have any more flavor and it's not supposed to be in there anyways.
No, whenever you have gum fall out of the wrapper in your purse and then
Oh, absolutely.
And then it's got like, it looks like it has freckles from all the tobacco.
Yes, absolutely. If I got yuck mouth, then yeah, go on in there. Like, it's fine.
I'm always worried that people will be like, "Ooh, do you have another piece of gum?"
No, like, you didn't want to see the last piece of gum I had. I do, but it looks worse than the one I just threw in my mouth. You don't want that.
You don't want that. It's not worth it.
Mm-mm. And you know what? I mean, when you say that, that's not the worst thing. I mean, who knows? Like I told you, I love to go to Mexico.
Uh-huh.
A lot of those places, I mean, they make do with what they got.
You know
what I mean? And I've had the best food. Am I 100% sure
that it was beef?
Yeah. No, I'm not at all. But did it taste amazing? Yes, it did.
As long as it tastes like what it's supposed to. But see, I'm into texture too. Believe it or not, I am kind of a picky eater.
I could have eaten some armadillo tacos.
And you wouldn't have known the difference.
I wouldn't have known the difference. And they tasted amazing.
I don't know. Tripe. Is it tripe?
Tripe menudo. Yes. Yeah. Tripe soup.
Yeah.
Menudo. Yeah. I don't really eat that. I used to love it as a kid. And then as an adult, a couple years back, I ate it somewhere. I cannot remember where. If you guys want to write, I know the name. I just don't want to put them on blast. Don't go there. I'm joking. I don't remember the name of the restaurant. But it was kind of nutty. And
you could taste the cow's last meal.
There was shit in there. There was definitely shit in there. I'm pretty sure there was some corn mixed in. I was like, why is there one lonely piece of corn floating around in my menudo? Yeah, it was, why is there alfalfa in my, and a little bit of cardboard, because you know pigs eat everything. Uh-huh. And I was, yeah, it was not good.
Is it pigs or cows? Or is it just a mixture of both?
It's the cow intestine. Uh-huh. It's the cow intestine. And, but you have to really, really clean it. I will eat it once in a great while if my mom makes it. But I mean, put it to you like that. Even if it's my mom's, I have to really think about it. If I'm going to eat it or not.
Mm.
And so I was just completely disgusted. And I haven't, and I used to love it as a kid. It's weird. And I always knew what it was. It's the shit bag. Tripe is just a fancy name, but it's the shit bag.
Uh-huh.
And you just have to really like scrub it and clean it and scrub it again. Ooh. And boil it and wash it and clean it again. It smells like shit when you're making it because it's a shit bag.
Mm-hmm.
And and it's chewy. Like, you're a texture person. You wouldn't like it. Mm-mm. And it looks disgusting.
Have you eaten tongue?
No, I won't. I won't even mess with that.
Really?
Nah, that I feel like it's mushy. Uh-huh. I don't know why. Everybody says it's tender. And when people say tender, that to me is mushy. I don't mess with. I don't really eat beef. Very rarely. Like, I'll go have a good steak. And mm-hmm. I have to know where I'm going to go eat. I just won't order a steak anywhere.
Mm-hmm. Well, because you shoot them.
That's exactly why. Because I put my foot on their head and look into their eyes. Don't and I tell that. Them.
People are going to be sending letters.
I know. And I look at them and I'm like, you're going to die. You're going to meet your humanely. Maker. I do it humanely. I don't put any of the cows in a chokehold and beat them. No. And I don't have to do it all the time. Just 99% of the time. But
it's humanely done. She's just joking.
I'm
relax.
Totally joking.
No hate mail. Come on.
Please. I just don't.
You'd much rather be shot by you than by somebody else. It's better now than what it was before, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And, I just don't care for, I mean, beef is good. Beef smells good until it's in front of me. Mm-hmm. And then I'm just kind of like, I don't
can't
know.
Do it.
Yeah, I'm just like, it just really depends on where it's from.
Mm-hmm.
And, can I say names of restaurants?
I mean, probably not.
I can't. No. I mean, it's a compliment. Maybe.
Okay, go for it.
Can I?
As long as it's a compliment.
It's a compliment. Like Farwood has good steak.
They have amazing steak.
Cattleman's. They have really good steak. I went there for the first
time. That's in Red Bluff, yeah.
That's really good. The steak I had there was really good.
Mm-hmm.
But it's very, like, far in between. Mm-hmm. The, you know, I had a steak on my birthday in July.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so it's just, I can count. I know when I eat beef.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not like ground beef. I really don't. If it's made with something, like say you made chili, I'll eat it.
Mm-hmm.
But carne asada I won't ever mess with. I can't.
Why?
I can't look at it. It's just looking at it. I don't know. It kind of grosses me out. I think it too depends on who's making it.
Mm-hmm.
If I've had a few beers in me and that's the only thing that's there, then I probably, because when you drink, you get hungry. You know?
Yeah.
I don't need to get drunk to be hungry. I'm always hungry. But for me to eat carne asada, I have to have some alcohol in me.
I can actually tell you where I had the best steak. The best steak I have ever had.
Where?
Ever. And it was in Weaverville.
Okay.
It was at a, we got a free night. It was when we first got together, me and my husband. We got together the day that we met. We were like, oh, we're together. We're going to move in. And so we got a free night at this place, and it was this hotel. It was like this, you know, you got a suite and then you had to drive to the golf course in order to get dinner.
Oh.
And you got a free dinner with it, with this suite and everything. It was a jacuzzi suite. And so we had, like, seriously, we took $6 with us, and that's all the money that we had. And we went and we stayed at the hotel, and we decided to go to the golf course. And it was like a skeevy where you walk in and there's like the regular that's sitting at the bar at the golf course smoking a cigarette and drinking, like, you know.
They had the Confederate flag hanging.
No, but they were like, you know, like the waitress's name was like Flo or Fanny or whatever, you know. And
yeah.
So we get there and it's like, it's scary. It's like 70 decor. And my husband looked at me and he goes, you better eat as much salad, because I highly doubt. It was supposed to be a steak and lobster dinner.
Uh-huh.
And he was like, eat all the salad and all the bread you can, because I can guarantee you it's going to be a shit meal. And they brought out our steak. I'm not kidding you. Our steak was the size of a hubcap. And
it was free?
Yeah. It came with the suite. It came with the room. And it was gifted to us, so it didn't cost us anything. And the lobster tail was like the size of my arm. It was the biggest steak and the biggest lobster.
It was a mutant lobster tail.
It looked like a freaking predator. It was so, or alien. It looked so freaking good, and it tasted just as good as it smelled. It was the best meal I had
ever
had.
Where is this? Is this place still open?
I think so. I think it was the Weaverville Inn is what it was. I don't know if it's still open or not. But
is Weaverville? I'm trying to think of where the, up north?
I don't know.
You don't know where Weaverville's at?
No.
I'm pretty sure, I could be wrong. I'm going to sound like an idiot, but I'm thinking that it's up north. maybe. I don't know.
I don't know.
I'll have to Google it.
But it was so good. And that was when I knew that we were destined to be together, because it was our first night away, like, as a couple. And I got champagne and I got confetti to put in the bed and I got a nightie. And things just turned to shit whenever we walked into the room. Like, he was like, I'm going to go start the water in the jacuzzi. I'm like, okay, I'm going to go slip into something comfortable. You get the champagne ready. And I go in there and I put the nightie on and I come out and he's buck naked inside the jacuzzi, sitting on the edge of it. And it wasn't, you're supposed to, most people don't know this, but we learned that you're supposed to fill the water up over the jets before you turn the jets on. And he turned the jets on before making sure the water was up. And I shit you not, it shot out like a water cannon. It hit the ceiling. It hit all the way to the window. Like, it was
horrible. It was like a drive-by in there.
It was horrible. And then we're like, okay. So we collected after that. We were like, okay, we got this. We dried everything down and then filled it up. And he's all, you want me to open up a bottle of champagne? Some bubbly.
Was it pink?
It actually was pink champagne. It tickled my nose.
Oh,
and he popped
such
it.
A lady.
He popped it and it flew and hit the lamp and broke and fell on the ground. And he was like, oh, fuck. So we do whatever. And
at least you weren't like, you know what? One more fuck up and we're just not meant to be.
We're going to power through this. We powered through it. And I had poured confetti in the bed whenever he was pooping after dinner. And he flipped the sheets back and he goes, ah, I go, what? He goes, you better call the maid because somebody left a big old mess in the bed. And I got X and O, like the metallic. Mylar, whatever confetti. And it was pink and blue and it stuck to us because we were soaking wet from the jacuzzi and the ink tattooed us. We had X and O's all over us. Like, I felt so sorry for the maid because we just, like, rolled up the sheet and just stuck it in the corner because he was like, I can't do this. I can't. Like, it's
going
all,
in my butt.
It's going in my butt. I'm worried that it's going to be up inside of you. Like, it could cause a lot of problems.
He was worried that he's going to be shitting out X's and O's for a month and a half.
It tattooed us. I'll never forget. He had an X on the tip of his nose and he had like a O on his eye and it was horrible. But yeah, that was the best steak and lobster dinner I have ever had in my entire life.
Have you gone to any of those places like the places that they bring you like a lobster in a bag?
Yeah, I went there. There's one in Chico.
Do you like them?
No.
Me neither. And you know what? I went.
There's a place in Chico that has it.
I went to a place in Sacramento a couple years ago, accompanied by somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And
name that we do not mention.
Yeah. And went with that person for their birthday. And I was like, you know, I'm going to order the lobster.
Uh-huh.
Because I'm fancy.
AF, yeah.
Yeah. And I'm going to order a lobster in a bag. So unbeknownst to me, when I say I want the lobster, I didn't know that they were going to bring me the whole lobster.
With the head and the tentacles and everything.
And the shit. Yeah. They didn't even de-shit it for me. I don't know if that's a word. But I was like, can you bring me like a spoon? Because I need to like take the shit out of this lobster. And honestly, lobster doesn't have that much meat. Is it called meat?
Yeah.
And I was just like, what am I going to do with this whole carcass that was like $130 with shit? You brought me a $130 carcass with shit. The least you could do is de-shit my lobster. After that, I was just like, not for me. No. I'm not impressed.
No.
I try to be fancy and order a lobster in a bag.
Well, you never, it's not really fancy when it's in a bag and you get a bib. Like,
and you know what?
There was like, eat with your fingers and you can pour the shit on the table.
You know what? I thought about that, but it's lobster. That's and it true. Was like $100 and something. And
well, it wasn't the meal. It was the destination. You were in the city. You pay extra. You pay extra for everything.
We were
city.
In a shithole.
It doesn't matter.
I think we got held up when we left. We got what they call in the city mugged. Here it was just I got clobbered in the head outside by my car. Over there we got mugged. No, yeah, it was kind of a sketchy part of town.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's not like we were in some uppity place. I think, like, there was a bail bonds place right next door and a liquor store on the other one.
Hair care, tire care right across the street.
It's like you could go get a Fody, which is a 40.
Ooh.
A 40 ounce. But in the city, they call it a Fody.
Fody.
A Fody, some condoms.
Uh-huh.
And go to jail and then go get bailed out by the place right next door.
Yes.
So, yeah. And then there was like a discount like clothing store.
Uh-huh.
Where everything was a dollar. So, I mean, this place was not... Yeah, a dollar. This place was not like an uppity area.
I've been to places like that. And I remember driving through one time, looking at our friend who was with us. And he was a cop. And the guy ahead of us in the other car was a cop. And they were, like, communicating through their side mirrors to each other. Mm-hmm. Like... We're driving because the GPS thing took us on a detour to this baseball game we were going to. And it took us through like the scary part of town where there was like a church with bars all over the windows. And like it was fucking terrifying. And he was like, if anything happens, you need to do this and this and this. And I was like, what are you talking about? Like, is this or like what's happening? Am I going to have to swallow my wedding ring? It was at some point you probably might want to think about it. It was terrifying. I think there was like a 2-year-old selling crack on the corner. It was horrible.
Is it Stockton?
I'm not going to say any names. No, it was not Stockton. No.
Okay.
No. But it was so scary. And I kept looking at him like, see, this is why I do not ever break my 5-mile radius rule. And I'm doing this for you.
Well, I'll tell you what, since I did mention Stockton has by far the most and the best places to eat.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not going to lie to you. Like, I will risk my life going there just to go to certain places to eat there because it is so good. They have some of the best Mexican restaurants. They have a place where you could get lasagna, and they even have a drive-thru. And I cannot. I would totally do a shout-out to them right now if I could remember the name. I'm going to have to figure out the name. But... it's like it comes with some type of bread. It's spelled, you know, English is my second language. So it's like, what is it called? It's with an F. It's a certain type of bread. I can't say it. It's this certain type of bread, this salad. I don't even like ranch dressing. And they have this ranch dressing that they use for their salad.
It was like made from the gods.
I swear, Jesus put his finger in that ranch. That's how good that ranch is. And they have a drive-thru. You could go and order a whole family dinner. Mm-hmm. And it's like your Italian grandma, if you were Italian, mm-hmm. made it. It's so good, you'd want to punch your grandma. Like, that's how good it is. It's so good that
see Jesus.
Yeah, it's so good that your Italian grandma has been making lasagna her whole life, and then you taste this lasagna and you go back and punch your grandma for making shit her whole life. That's how good it is. And I mean, it's amazing. And there's a Chinese place that place, it's something star. I can't remember. But this place literally looks like it's condemned. It looks from outside. It looks like people have died there.
Oh, my God.
It looks like you're risking going in because you're probably not going to come out.
Mm-hmm.
And that Chinese food is amazing. Yeah. They have the best places to eat. But there are so many places in one city. Like, like usually you'll be like, oh, I have to go over here to have something good. In that city, they have the best food. It doesn't matter what it is.
Didn't you say you were pissed off that somebody ended up taking your idea to go to Disneyland and eat all the food?
Yes. Okay. So, you know that I love Disneyland. That's my happy
place. Disneyland is your happy place.
It is my happy place. Like you say, when you got to, what's it called? Where's that city we were just talking about?
New Orleans.
New Orleans. You cried when you left. I cry when I get to Disneyland, and I cry when I leave. And I absolutely love it. I am smiling the whole time, and you know me well. Uh-huh. I am not a cheery person.
You're not.
And I just absolutely love it. And a couple years ago, I thought, you know what would be a good idea is to do like a blog and go and try out, because Disneyland's always coming out with new food. And I'm the first to say a lot of the food is very overrated and overpriced at Disneyland.
Oh, God.
So it's very overpriced. But there is some stuff, if you find it, that it's worth it. Like, yeah, I'm going to pay $30 for this cupcake because it's that good. And it's Disneyland. Like my candy apples. I always get my candy apples at the Carnation Cafe.
Uh-huh.
And I get them on the last day that I'm there. It's the last thing that I do before I leave Disneyland on my last day. It's my routine. I have a routine when I go to Disneyland. So that's what I do on the last day. And I go and get my caramel apples and candy apples. I get about 18 of them.
You spend the other part of your son's college.
Yes.
Fun.
Yes. And I love those candy apples. Those are worth every single dollar. And honestly, they're not even that expensive. Uh-huh. I want to say that they're less than $5. They're amazing. But a lot of the food is shit. I'll be honest. Like, I mean, it's not shit, but
you spend $15 for a freaking pretzel.
Yeah, it's not. It's what I really like is the chocolate covered bananas, the frozen ones. Mm-hmm. Those are really good. And then the candy apples. But I wanted to do a blog where you just go and you're trying out new stuff. And then I psyched myself out. I second guessed myself and I didn't do it. And then I went on YouTube the other day and I saw two fucking nerds with that idea. And I was just like, and it, you know what? And they're obnoxious. They're so obnoxious. And you know who you are. I don't care if you hear this. You have a shit stained birthmark on your cheek. The girl. And I don't care if you hear this. She's a nerd and she's obnoxious. Their personality is very fake. And I feel it's like almost like they're trying to do a show. And me, it would have just been like me talking. And I would have been like taking a bite out of something. I've been like, this is shit. You know, don't waste your money on it. Buy this instead. You know,
it would be better if you did this.
Yeah. You would be, you know, don't even bother walking the extra 3 miles to Disney Adventure to eat this because you could have this in Disneyland, which I love both equally. Yeah. I love Disney Adventure. But I'm just saying, like, they're trying all these foods. And I'm not going to lie. Their material's getting stale.
Uh-huh.
They've been trying the same
you
shit.
You should do it. You should, like,
I should go and kick their ass. No. That's what I should go do. I'd be like, hey, fucking nerd,
she's
you.
She's just kidding. No. She's just kidding. Relax.
Oh, it's like,
calm down.
All of a sudden, I turned into, like, one of the outsiders.
I know.
And I was like, let's rumble.
It was my idea.
It was my idea. And
imagine,
but you
what
know
the
what?
Guy that, yeah.
That's why I'm so glad that you did this. I remember when you talked to me about doing this and you're just like, should I, and I slapped you on the face, which I do sometimes.
Yes,
you know, because I can get kind of handsy.
Yeah, just a smidge.
It was just a little smidge. And after you're like, don't do that, and slap me back, I was like, you have to do it, because I so regret not doing it. I so regret not doing it. And I'm like thinking, those two nerds put together, I'm better than them. And I would put more detail, and I wouldn't have been, they're kind of phony-ish. Their personality is kind of phony-ish. They're kind of trying to turn, I feel like they're trying to turn it into a TV show with their phony, nerdy personality because they're fucking nerds. And me,
you're,
I would have just
been
like.
You're jealous that you.
I'm so jealous of them.
I know. That's, I can tell. I think you need, but once you have a thought of something that you want
to
do it.
You have to do
you
it.
You have to do
you
it.
You have to
you
do it.
You can't sit back and just be like, okay. In like we were saying, the number 23, which is a big joke for us. But I don't care if only 23 people listen to this. I don't really care if only 5 people listen to this.
Yeah.
Because you know what?
Because
at the end of the day, it doesn't matter because I'm doing something fun and.
And you wanted to do this.
And I wanted to do this. And I don't give a shit if I don't get paid. I'm not going to get paid for it. I
don't care. Obviously.
It's just for fun.
Yeah. Shout out to Parwood again, though, just in case you guys want to.
Avocado fries.
Not for me. She likes avocado fries. Nothing against you guys. It's just I don't like avocado. But if you guys want to,
they have the best ahi nachos ever on the planet.
I always order the same thing when I go there. It's always a chicken Caesar salad or a steak
or booze.
Yeah, they have pretty good bartenders. I like Farwood. Farwood's a good place.
It is. It's amazing.
Once again, I'm not sponsored by you guys, but if you guys want to buy my lunch one day, I will not turn that down.
You could actually start a blog where you go in and pick one restaurant like,
and I'll be like, this is
for
shit.
A week. No. And you could order everything. You have to eat everything on the menu.
I'm not
within
eating
30
avocado
days.
Fries.
But you could have somebody eat it for you, like moi.
Okay.
And I could give a.
You could be
I
my
could
guest.
Tell you. Yeah, but you have like, wouldn't that be cool? Like, you go in every single day to the same restaurant for and however many items are on the list. You have to do breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and if they have it, and then you give a play-by-play of what it is.
You know what? I think I'd be so good at that. And
you
I'm
would.
I'm going to tell you why.
Why?
Because. I'm very sensitive to smell and taste. Like, that's why I am the way I am with beef.
Uh-huh.
I could, if I smell it cooking, I could tell you, like, that cow ate this. Because I could, when I'm smelling it, I could taste it. So, ergo. I don't know. I'm just really mad that those fucking nerds stole my idea.
I'm so jealous.
I don't know where I was going.
I'm
going
to say such mean things because I'm so jealous of them. Yeah. We want to be you.
I just am so mad. I want to rumble with them and just be like, whoever's better at this has to leave and never come back. You can only come back as a normal person.
Yeah.
You can't even get a Disney season pass.
I went to Disneyland. I did enjoy it. It was great. However... it's a lot of freaking walking, man. And it's a lot of people and strollers.
I have
never seen so many freaking strollers in my entire life ever. Like, there was so many fucking strollers that they were like three deep at every single ride. And then you turn and it's like 2 hour wait.
Well, you should have sat in one.
Yeah,
tempted. You could have gone to customer like services.
I got a scooter for my husband, and that was by far the best thing I ever did.
You should have thrown him off and gotten on too.
I did a couple times. I was like, "Mama's got to sit."
And you know what? They're not going to ask you like, "What's wrong?" I'm lazy. Okay, here you go.
I'm fat. I have a thyroid problem. For God's sakes.
Yeah, and you know what? This is the level of love I have for Disneyland. If I someday ever get married, I would really, I don't even give a shit if I get married. I want to have my bridal shower. Doesn't matter if there's a marriage involved in there at all. I want to have a bridal shower at Disneyland. That's what I want to do.
You know what I want to do? I want to stay at one of the hotels inside the park. I saw that there's like a VIP. Somebody told me it's like a VIP list where there's only certain people you have to pay a certain amount in order to be on the list. I'm not sure if that's true or not. I'll have to Google it.
For the castle?
No, I don't know if it's for the castle or if, like, it's down by the log ride or something where it's this beautiful hotel that's right in the middle of the park.
No, you don't have to be on a list to get there. You have the Disneyland Resort. You have the Paradise.
Maybe it is the castle.
Pier. For the list, for the castle, you actually have to get chosen to
that's
be in
what
that
it was.
After
yeah.
you pay like $1 million.
Yeah.
Like, it's ridiculous. There's a restaurant there too that you can get a membership. And
is it the Blue Bayou?
It's by there. No, it's not the Blue Bayou. It's right by there though. And you have to like make a shit ton of money. So we're not in at all.
No.
Even together.
No.
Even
they're not gonna want my $75.63 out of my checking account.
Yeah. And the way that my checking account works is you actually have to have money in there. So
yeah, you have a really pretty card though that goes with it.
I do.
It's got the strip on the back. It looks very official.
Very
it
official.
It has numbers on it.
Nothing. I have no value.
No.
I have
none.
No value.
None.
And I'm just like, I got this gas card with rewards.
I think I have a Cinemark gift card and a C's candy, and I'll just slide it over with a couple dollars and be like, ah, make
here
mama
you, look,
happy.
I'd be like, look, I didn't want to have to show off.
Yeah,
but here's my C's
and my Cinemark
and my Speedway gas station. Is
go.
That what it's called? The new gas station, it used to be Shell. I don't know.
Yeah,
what it's,
I think so.
Speed something.
Speedway. Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. I'd be like, and here's my $5 Taco Bell coupon I got.
And my Dutch Brothers card full of stamps.
Oh, you don't want to let that go.
I would be willing to do it to stay in a castle like the princess that I am.
Yeah. And you know what I'm so excited about is that a couple years ago, I tried to go get a princess makeover and they're like looking at me like I was crazy. And they're like, it's just for kids. And so I was like, hold on, let me go grab somebody's. And they looked at me weirder when I said that. And so I was just like, you know,
like
what?
Like Amber Alert.
Yeah. Yeah. So I was like, you know what? I didn't want to get my makeup done here anyways, even though I left really sad. Like, mm-hmm. my eyes got teary and everything because they didn't want to do it. But they do it now.
Yeah, I know.
Probably because I pitched a fit.
You changed lives.
I did.
Did I tell you? We took my daughter to that. Mm-hmm. And she, so I asked her because we went during Halloween and I said, what do you want to be for Halloween? We're going to do the Bippity Boppity Boutique. And she said, I really want to be Belle. And I was like, okay. Trying to find a Belle dress. I don't know why, but it was a pain in the ass to try and find one. And I finally found one. And it was so full of glitter and poofy and had all this tulle underneath it.
It was glorious.
It was glorious. And I said, this isn't going to fit in the bag because it's going to be horrible. I hand carried that thing through the airport in Long Beach.
You make it sound like through it was 800 pounds.
Through the airport. Like, I made sure that nothing happened to this dress. We get her to the Bippity Boppity Boutique, and guess what? I forgot it at the hotel. And they were like, she has to have the dress on before we do her hair because, you know, I kicked my husband off of his scooter and I went to the hotel.
You hauled ass.
I hauled ass as fast as I could. Came back.
Isn't it like 3 miles per hour?
Yes. It was like. And we get there. I get back and I get her in there and get her checked in and put the. We had to finagle away because they don't have an area where the dressing rooms were completely packed. So we're at the drawbridge. Like, trying to be a human shield outside the Bippity Boppity Boutique to get this dress on her. Long story short, we get our hair done, get everything. And they said, you know, they were putting this thing on top of her head. You know, Belle has brown hair, but we have all these extensions for an additional $25 for extensions on top of your hair. What color would you like? I'm like, well, brown, obviously, because that's what color her hair is. And that's what color Belle's hair is. And my daughter looked at me and she said, and I said, there's no reason for an extension because her hair is already brown. Like, it'll save me $25. And my daughter looked and goes, I want blonde extensions on top. I'm like,
of course she does.
What? And I said, I am not paying $25 for blonde extensions for you to wear a Belle dress and then not even look like fucking Belle. And she goes, that's what I was thinking in my head. And then she looked at the lady and the lady goes, well, don't you want brown? And she goes, that's what color the princess is brown hair. And my daughter looked and goes, yeah, but my mommy has blonde hair on top of her hair. And I went,
so you forked out the
$25. So I was like, how much? And so I ended up paying it. It made me so happy. We get back to the hotel to go take a nap or not take a nap, but pick everybody up and go back to the park. And she looks at me and says, this dress is really itchy. I want to wear my Incredibles t-shirt. So my daughter looked like a zebra. And on top of her hair, she had blonde and brown hair and an Incredibles t-shirt and a pair of shorts. And did not look anything like Belle, but she had her hair done and her makeup on and she felt fancy as fuck. And that's all that matters. But still, I hand carried that dress. Well, I think I left it in the hotel whenever we left. I was so pissed off because she wanted to be Belle. That's what she wanted. And then I make it happen and she's like, not for me.
And did you get that dress in Disneyland?
No, I got it in the mall, I think it was. And it was like an authentic Belle dress. Like, it had the signature Disney. It was like the Disney store. Yeah, it was like authentic with like the sash and the tulle and it was freaking legit. And
I got my son when he was little, he was obsessed with Pirates of the Caribbean.
Mm-hmm.
So I got him the Captain Jack Sparrow mm-hmm. costume when he was little.
That shit ain't cheap.
Oh, it was no lie. It was probably over $200.
Oh, I believe it.
And I got it at what is it called? Downtown Disney. Mm-hmm. That's where I got it at. But he won the Halloween costume at school, so, I mean, worth it. And he looks so cute. I know I'll have to show you a picture. I drew the little mustache on him. I was like, let Mama draw her eyebrows on, and then she'll draw on your...
She'll take care of
yeah,
that for
then
you.
I'll draw the mustache on. And he looks so adorable, and it literally had a wig.
Uh-huh.
And it was the braids, and it was a legit... It was clothes. Like, it was clothing. That costume was of such high quality, and this is how big of a dick I am. My brother's like, oh, you're going to have to save it for one of your nephews. And I was like, absolutely not.
No.
I don't want anybody. So we, I mean, I put it away. I won't. No, it was $200. If he could fit into it now at 17, I'd make him wear it. And
you're so, wearing this to prom.
You're wearing this to prom on your graduation day.
Any day.
Yeah. Like, yeah. I just, no, absolutely nobody. I don't care who it is.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, maybe if one of my dogs wanted to wear it as a cute little picture, aww, I'd probably let them. But no other kid. No,
nobody.
But I got that for him. He was probably about 5. And no lie, I probably enjoy Disneyland more than he does.
Oh, I bet.
And I even told him, because he's graduating in 2021. He's going to graduate. He's going to be a junior this year.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he's a junior this year. And so I told him, when you graduate high school, we're going to go to Disney World,
mm-hmm,
for like a week and a half.
Mm-hmm.
And he's just like, okay, is that for me or is that for you? I'm all, shut up. Quit being ungrateful.
I was in labor for 98 hours.
Yeah. Yeah,
cut
like
from hip to hip.
Yeah, I always tell him that. I'm like, you know, when they cut me, and he's just like, oh God, get over it already.
Being so dramatic.
Yeah, he thinks I'm being so dramatic. And I'm just like, I was in labor for like 3 days. And
but it's a long time.
It's a long time.
So okay, so before we wrap this up, which we're gonna have to, I wanna talk to you about our adventure that we were gonna do.
Yes.
So we have this thing where you went on a hike.
I go hiking.
You go hiking.
I go hiking.
Okay, whatever.
Come on. If you're going to say it right. I go hiking. I'm a hiking extraordinaire.
Connoisseur.
Connoisseur.
You like it.
I love it.
So you hiked for 4 miles.
What are you talking about?
And then 4 miles back down, right?
Let's say it right. You're trying to steal my thunder on this one. It was 9.5 miles.
So you're saying then Hamilton City from my house to Hamilton is probably what? 12 miles?
Probably about that, yeah, because it's 10 miles. Orland to Hamilton.
Okay, so I think it's going to take us...
I did the hike in about 4 hours.
It's going to take us about that to walk from here.
I don't think it's going to take that.
I think it is. And you know that I don't like leaving. So we have this thing where we're going to put to the test. We're going to walk from one city to the other. We're going to walk to Hamilton. And I think it's a stupid idea. And you're making me do it with you.
Because you think I'm full of shit.
I think you are full of shit.
I think at the most, it's going to take about 2.5 hours.
It's going to take us more than that.
No, it's not. Because look.
Can I get a scooter?
No.
Oh.
If we're at a steady pace, you're on flat ground. Okay. That hike that I did, we were like busting a move. That's what I mean. Okay, we were busting to move through there because it was agony. I thought I was gonna die in there, and I just wanted to hurry up and get out. Me and one of my best friends, we went. We were totally unprepared. I took pictures the morning before I went on the hike, and I for me, which is normal, on the picture it looks like 3 people's breakfast, but it wasn't. It was my breakfast. And
it was first breakfast.
It was breakfast. Yeah, I only had one breakfast. And, but it was huge. It was a lot of food. And
where'd you guys go hiking at though?
We went to the Featherfall hike, like, up by, Orville.
Uh-huh.
So we did.
So you went to breakfast before your hike.
Yeah. Cause I was like, let's have a big breakfast. We're going to burn that off.
Mm-hmm.
And, it didn't even occur to us to take more food. Like a snack, because I was like, I had like a huge breakfast. I had, no lie, I had French toast. I had French toast, 4 slices of French toast. I still know what I ate. I had 4 slices of French toast, bacon, eggs, sausage, an order of hash browns. I had corned beef and hash, which I needed more hash browns for that.
Mm-hmm.
I had sourdough toast. And I think I might have, just to top it off, I probably had chicken fried steak.
Just a little bit. Girl.
That's a meal for me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I had that, and I was like, okay, I'm feeling good. Let's do this hike. So we went, but it didn't occur to us to, like, let's take some trail mix. Let's take some crackers. Nothing. We didn't take anything but water. That's all we took.
Oh, my.
And no lie, afterwards, like, I wanted to die. Uh-huh. I literally wanted to die. Shit was looking foggy to me after a while. Like,
you were hallucinating.
I was hallucinating again. And it, my feet, I, you saw how I walked. Mm-hmm. Like, I didn't take the proper shoes. I had a pair of my trainers on, which I use for the gym, which are super thin, mm-hmm. super thin and light, no type of support. And then I thought it would be a good idea to just wear the, like, the thin, thin, thin socks, which is, like, no socks.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, like, I didn't.
You were unprepared.
I was very unprepared. My poor friend, she ended up having, like, when we got out of there, her fingers were blue. And I think it was because of the, where we were at.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, the lack of oxygen. I don't know what it is. We ended up going to one of the casinos to eat. And I had a huge steak dinner. Put it to you like this. I was so hungry, I wanted to order another one. Another steak dinner. And my friend talked me out of it because she said that would embarrass her if I ordered another steak dinner. That's how hungry I was, though, afterwards. And she ended up going to the emergency care afterwards.
Ugh.
And because she just, like, her sugar dropped so mm-hmm. fast. And they said that we burnt the equivalent of, like, 3 days worth of calories in the hike that we did. So I could have died
because
I didn't have enough food. And
we need to make sure that we take snacks because I don't want that to happen. I don't want to turn blue.
I don't even think we're going to need snacks because it's not really a hike. We're going to be walking on flat ground. And that's why I think it's only going to be like 2.5 hours.
I think it's going to be like 3.
I don't think it is.
I think it is.
I don't think, I feel like it's going to be like 2 hours.
I don't know.
Actually,
I'm going to take Uncrustables. And I'm going to take some pretzels.
You're going to take a barbecuer.
My propane tank.
We'll make hot dogs. And
I'll make sure that I take my turkey with brine. So that way we could just smoke it on my way. It's going to be, I'm not going to lie to you. The only reason why I'm doing it is because I love you. And because I want to prove you wrong.
No.
And because I'm thinking that if we go there, we could stop at that one place.
At the little Mexican market to get the chicken.
And get chicken. Yes. And yeah. Ribs. Best place. Awesome.
Toro Loco, in case you guys want to give us chicken and
it is
and
amazing.
Ribs. You guys have the, and you know what? You had never tasted chicken like that.
No, right? I've never eaten ribs. So,
in case you guys haven't gotten it, I'm Hispanic, and I've been introducing Monica
yes.
to different types of things, and I brought her a chicken from the little Mexican market on 32. In Hamilton City. It's called a Toro Loco. In English, that means the crazy bull. So they have like one of those big, not barrels, but like how they do the tri-tip.
The big barbecues.
The yeah. big barbecues. They have one of those. They do it every day. Ribs and chicken.
Mm-hmm.
That chicken, do you remember I brought it to you?
Yes.
And
Jesus. You were going to be like, oh, here you go.
I thought that you guys, you know what? I'm not going to lie. I thought that you guys were just going to taste it.
Oh, no, we devoured it.
You guys ate my food.
If there was only bones and if there was feathers, that's all that would be left.
Yeah.
There was cartilage and bones left.
Randy got up just to come in because I remember I brought it into the shop.
Oh, what is that?
Yeah. And it was amazing.
It was the best chicken. But the ribs, I remember the meat just fell off the bone.
Yeah. It has such good flavor.
And they were old. Like, it was a couple hours old, and
oh,
it was
yeah.
still freaking good.
It was
oh
amazing, yeah. Because I remember I was like, do you guys have any ribs? And they're like, we have one rib left. And I was like, give it to me. It's like 18 hours old. No, I'm joking. It's not. But it was from earlier.
Yeah.
It was from earlier in the day.
So freaking good. Amazing.
Yeah.
So as long as you promise that we can go there.
We will.
And then we're going to have
hey,
to
we'll
park.
Just walk there, and we'll be like, we're here for the chicken.
Give yeah. me some chicken, some ribs, and a pack of cigarettes, and I'm out.
Yeah, and what's cool is that the corn lady stands outside that market, too.
I can't eat corn. That'll make my teeth hurt.
Oh, they have the mongoladas.
What's that?
Mongoladas, like, I don't even pronounce it correctly in Spanish. People call it, they all say it different. So I call it a mongolada.
Is it a fruit cup?
It's like shaved ice.
Oh.
With a mango. It's mango. Chunks of mango in it, like a syrup.
Uh-huh.
So good. It's so good. I get heartburn. I know you always say I'm the worst Mexican because I can't.
You are.
I can't eat anything spicy. Them, I always tell them, like, just a little bit of chile, which means just a little bit
poquito
of
chile.
Poquito chile. And because I'll get really bad heartburn. So, or I'll just eat like 18 Tums. mm-hmm. and then I eat one.
You're like, worth it.
It's so good.
Get in my belly.
I'll have to get one. Mm-hmm. Even right now, they'll be out there. Even in the cold, doesn't matter. Because wow. that's how we roll.
That's how you do it.
But yes.
All right. Well, let's wrap this up.
Okay.
So what do we got going on? So I'm really excited about this. I'm
excited for you.
Thank you.
And it's kind of like you doing this. It's kind of like an F you to those nerds exactly. at Disneyland. You know who you are.
No, this is going to be fun. I think this is a good adventure. Even if nobody listens to it, it's something that we could just do. And
if you don't listen to it, I'll kick your ass. Just joking. No. My friend Monica is amazing. So you guys have to listen
sweet.
To her.
You're sweet.
I make you more amazing, though.
You do. You help. You're definitely a bonus. So we will keep everyone updated on our trip to Hamilton City. I'm sure we're going to talk about it, and then...
Can we wait till it just gets, like, not cold? You know how cold I am all the time. Can we wait till it's not, like, storming outside?
Yeah. I think we should add elements to it, though, to make it harder.
Okay.
But that's just me. I don't know. We will play it, as they say, by ear.
Okay. Okay.
So, yeah, this is our first episode of No Conditions podcast for... Literally everything. It's going to be a podcast that you could talk about whatever you want. And I'm going to have guests, surprise guests. I have people coming on, some you know, some you don't. And it'll just be worth a listen. So, I'm super stoked. I want to thank Paloma for coming and starting the first episode out with me. And I hope this works. And if it doesn't, at least it's for us. You guys could like us on Facebook, Instagram, and subscribe on YouTube. It'll be up and running January 2020. And I can't wait. If you guys are listening to this, and this means that it already got uploaded, hit the subscribe button and you can listen to future episodes. So thanks, everybody. I appreciate it. Paloma, I thank you for all that you do and all that you are. And we will keep you all updated. So take care. God bless. Out.
Bye.